Mubuku Irrigation Scheme, a government-funded irrigation project established in the 1960s to ensure agricultural productivity, besides acting as a training ground for farmers, seems to have taken a new shape after the Land Commission directed for the cancellation of all titles on this 200-acre land early this year. This time, farmers have petitioned the irrigation scheme, accusing a one Lawrence K. Tebisi of using his office to sell more than 3.2 hectares of land of the experimental farm to a one Maria Goretti Chohairi, as stated in the first paragraph of their petition. In the same document, the farmers captured the repercussion of the action. The State Minister of Agriculture, Christopher Kibazanga, noted that although they didn't respond to the farmers' petition immediately, they were aware of the nasty activities eating up the government-funded project.
And then there are people who have given themselves blocks and blocks of land. There are people who have leased the irrigation scheme land. There are people who have changed the land use of irrigation scheme. Some of them have changed the blocks into plots to build permanent houses. Some of them have even blocked the water channels. So all those criminality are going on in our occupations.
In July last year, government through the Ministry of Agriculture and security agencies directed all farmers and visiting institutions to access the facility without releasing a single coin. But this directive allegedly fell on deaf ears, as officers are reported to be charging 1,500 Ugandan shillings per head.
They made a memorandum of understanding under the lawyer. They give receipts. They receive money, they have workers, there are terms of reference in place, and the contract agreements are in place. The role of Ministry of Agriculture, Animal Industry and Fisheries is to supervise and to ensure quality assurance.
And the Mubuku Irrigation Scheme was set for the younger people to learn and to love agriculture. And now when you make them pay, you are making it commercial. For who? For the Ministry, for yourself. And the Ministry set it up to teach the youth on how to farm, modern farming, and how to love agriculture. And when you are coming to inspect, you put a levy. A levy for what? Where do you put that in? So we are going to investigate all this.
Besides promoting mechanization, government's objective to prioritize the scheme was to ensure constant food production to curb food insecurity in the area and the country at large. Previous reports had also shown that the scheme has elevated lives of the farmers who produce beans, rice, and hot peppers, among others. This report by Hassan Kagure for Urban TV.